Serious talk for a minute or two here, because I don't know how aware people are of the whole Gamergate and Zoe Quinn and stuff and things. Wow, my frame rate is tanking right now. But wrong button. Yeah, it's a mess anyway, but it seems to have actually worked out well for Pixel Judge, because with everything that's been going on, people have lost faith in a lot of the bigger sites, especially after they posted that whole game as a
such
dead
calamity and destruction thing lay before me, held up by no discernible force.
I think this
I was in awe for
like
the first
carbon
time since I came into this world. True awe.
But yeah,
kind only God can command. Was this his work then? I didn't know at the time, but I would indeed meet the power behind this creation.
His Kotaku, Polygon, some other people, they all pretty much did the same thing, a copy-paste. Gamers are dead because misogyny, you killed it, blah 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 blah. Which is frankly idiotic. Gaming is like the biggest growth industry in history. So, yeah, obviously, not dead. Anyway, it's led to a lot of people, understandably, being a little bit irritated and started to look for other websites, and some of them stumbled across me, had conversations, because whether I like it or not, it's something I kind of have to pay attention to. Oh, do I need to get this to anyway? It is something I have to pay attention to because, aha! Right. Because whether I like it or not, I am now a video game journalist. So, but yeah, I was talking to them and they've added us to a list of, like, you know, gamers, journalists with integrity, so. I mean, that's a good thing, don't get me wrong. I'm really pleased that people are starting to pay attention to us now in a lot of ways, but that therein lies the problem. You know, this is good for Pixel Judge. It means we're in a much stronger position now to really make a name for ourselves, because a lot of the competition is going to become very much a niche thing as people lose interest in them because of some of the chivalrous that they've been getting up to. Down here, but I can't help but feel like I'm somehow capitalizing on that, and that leaves that leaves me with a feeling that I don't quite like, which I think is something, at least I hope, is something that people will agree shows just how much integrity I actually do have. I feel uncomfortable with monopolizing on that for our ends, but you know, what can you do? Wow, my frame rate's tanking again. It's probably though because I'm uploading at the moment as well, maybe. So, because I mean, you saw, well, I hope you saw from my previous recording that I can handle this game just fine. Hey, dude. Make of that what you will. I mean, we are putting a lot of effort into making Pixel Judge a success. Of course we want to be successful. Yeah? But we want to do it the right way. Brave words, right? Such a noble thing to say, such a noble sentiment. I just feel really, really hope that we can maintain our principles. So I'm sure that Kotaku and Polygon and I can't remember the names of the rest of them, Game Sutra and whatever and stuff, I'm sure they all set out with principles as well, and I'm sure many of them really do genuinely, fervently believe they're doing the right thing. Just, yeah. Well, they're not. Sorry, but they're just not. Don't go around and say things like that about your audience. It's just asinine. Gotta be like me saying you're all morons for watching my life. Well, I do think you're a bit silly for watching my life, but there are people out there who are far more entertaining. Like my girlfriend, for example. It's a lot more effort into it. And then I just record the game, split it into 20-minute chunks, and hey presto. Yeah, instead of putting a bit more effort in now, someone like... so far as I've been in Red Dead Redemption, but I've put, like... stuff in there that's like images and scripts. So things and scripts. So I think I get this now. Yeah, this is just leading back to where it was. Okay. Here's my app. What the hell is that? Anyway. Yeah. It does leave me feeling extremely uncomfortable that we're getting something out of this. Yeah, you know, I was talking to people about how I was involved in a video game website, and we wanted to make a name for ourselves. And I deliberately didn't give the name because, you know, I didn't feel it was right to be advertising. The chap I was talking to just went and found out who I was. And, you know. Well, I mean, it's not like I hide that. I probably just went straight to my YouTube profile. Mentioned on there, to my Twitter or something. I don't hide things on there, but at the same time, I didn't just want to go saying curviness because, wow, frame rate tanking, stop it, down to 6. Pick it up. Thank you. Right. Okay, now here's my plan. Get on there. Put that there, and then that should roll down there, and then once that's finished, once I guess, yeah, there we go. Gee, I know my shifts. I know how to do these things. I know the puzzles of the stuffs. I know the stuffs of the stuffs. I know the stuffs of the chervinus. Anyway, shall we move on from that now and get on to this? I really should have finished this by now, just had a look. I started playing The Crew. The beta. I want a preview of that. And I'm not usually into car games, but that one really caught my attention and I played it, and I must have put something like 30 hours into it. At least. It was really fun. And it looked amazing. A lot of people complaining that it was wrong, but it was running at only 30 frames per second.
30 frames per second in the slide, yo, you can't even play a game.
Wow, you must have hated growing up in the 80s then, when the frame rate was 8. Yes, 8. We had 8 frames per second. 8. Freaking 8. I may do with 8. Okay. Ah, up there. I need to get something for this. Right. And that comes back. Stop going crazy chervinous. Of the chervers of the stuffs. Chervadicks. Ish. Go down there. Anyway, stuff and things. Right, I need something to put in here. Now, I wonder... Yeah, that should work. If I roll this... Pick it up. If I roll this down... Down... Okay. If I roll this down yon hill, Roll it down, Phil. Where's it gone? Come here, you. Pick it up. Roll you down, Phil. And I stand here. And as soon as it reaches that, I go through there. There we go. Yes. Okay. Oh, it's actually loaded. Was that it? I must have missed a section there, because there was one of the gates I just sort of walked past and ignored. Wasn't there? Oh, hello. Hello, indeed. Hello, location. Hello. Hello, co-location. You know what? I'm gonna go and just do a quick wibble, because I can't play with 7 frames per second. Even I kind of draw the line these days anyway, so I'll be right back. Wasn't what I thought it was. I moved my video file, Red Faction if you're interested, to my main, to my main drive, to one of my other drives. I thought that was probably the problem, but it wasn't the data access right on the hard drive, which is usually the first thing I think. Oh, invisible wall, shame. Usually the first thing I think of when I'm getting performance is just going wibble. Turns out it was the amount of the amount of anti-aliasing I had switched on via Catalyst Control Center. I have it at 8 times EQ, extra quality, with adaptive multi-sampling. I turned it down to 2 times EQ, and I'm now getting a nice stable 30. I noticed that my frame rate was 7, even after I'd finished moving the thingy bob, so it definitely was not Fraps that was causing the problem. Oh, that's a shame. I don't like things like that. I don't like invisible walls. I mean, why have it open like that if you can't go through it? Oh, what's all this then, I wonder? If I jump on this, can I... Alright, well, let's go find out what all this is about. Let's head down this way. Anyway, yeah, I watched the first season of The Walking Dead today. I don't get it. I just don't get it. I do not understand why people love that series so much. As far as I am concerned, The Walking Dead exists solely in my Steam library. Yeah, love the game. Well, I've only played season 2 so far, but I absolutely adore that game, which is kind of obvious by now, considering I've uploaded the entirety of my life. Well, I've uploaded it all. I haven't made it all live, but final part of episode 5 is scheduled to go live today, later today, so it's already uploaded and set and stuff. But yes, I do not understand why that series is so popular. I really just don't get it. It is so full of contrivance and stupid people doing stupid things. I just did not feel anything for any of them. Even Andrew Lincoln's character. And I adore Andrew Lincoln. I mean, like, serious bromance going on there with him. I mean, he made me want to be a teacher because he was in a TV series called Teachers. Yeah, contrary to popular belief, Andrew Lincoln is not an American. He does a great American accent, I'll give him that. But he's actually from London. I knew a guy. Wait, no, he's not from London. He's a northerner. He's a northerner. What am I talking about? I actually knew a guy who knew him personally. You know, properly. Friends and stuff. So, yeah. He is a fellow Brit. He is a fellow tea drinker. That's a nice cup of tea he does, the lad. But, yeah, even him. I mean, the character himself wasn't... He was one of the better characters. I will give you one thing. I can understand why Daryl is so popular. He was a very interesting character. He was a very good, well-rounded character. I will definitely give you that. But the rest of them was just a bunch of idiotic people doing idiotic things. I didn't feel any connection with them, and they didn't get enough screen time for their plight to have any real emotional depth. Hello? I mean, some of the scenes where some of the people died, you're like, you should be really...
Forest.
feeling
there was
something,
a definite
but...
tree motif going on. That much was obvious. The thalamus should have clued me in from the start. It's difficult to miss such a ridiculously ginormous tree. This pattern could be just as random as many other things in this crazy world, but... I knew that wasn't the case. I climbed that tree and survived the tsunami. Sophia stayed in the swing set, and I didn't help her climb.
Oh, it was so a tsunami.
Had I blinked, I wouldn't have been able to see the water violently swallow her whole. I didn't blink.
Okay, now what? Right, so what are we supposed to gather from all this, then? Is that done? Does that do anything? Nope, doesn't seem to. Right, so he's aware of the fact that this is going on inside his own noggin, then. Yeah, let's go back to theorising about that. Commenting on the game. You know, that's just kind of what you come here for, I think. I don't know, why do you come to my videos? I mean... yeah. Of all the people available, I'm getting some views and stuff, so I must be doing something right. I'm just wondering, what is it? Is it the fact that I'm not like everybody else, that I just sort of have a nice friendly chat? Well, there are other people who do that too, and I wager there are other people who do it better than I do. I know I tend to belabor the point a little bit here, but my partner, she does a great job. She's kind of like that, okay. Isn't this where I just came from? Yeah, so these are like, now these ones are more like shortcuts. Alright, fair enough. Ah, there's already one down there, come here. Right then, let's see what happens when I take them both out. Put one there, yep, that's good. And then, come here, yep. See what happens when I get you out of here. You can stay there. Stay. Yeesh. Right. Oh, I meant to do some reading up on the thalamus. It's been a while since I've read about the thalamus. Actually, the thalamus is the one that's about memory and stuff, isn't it? Okay, let's follow those. They seem potentially important. Could just well be missed effects. Yeah, probably are just missed effects. Alright. Okay. So yeah, anyway, what was I saying? Why are you here? Watching this? Listening to me ramble on about random rambliness. Because that's pretty much all I really do. I mean, I watch back through all of my content at least once. I'm not one of those who is shy about what I've done. I'm also not going to deny that... oh, that is beautiful. I'm also not going to deny that part of the reason I do it is I watch through every single one of my episodes before I make them live. Partly so I can choose a name for it rather than trying to remember everything on the fly. You know, I'll watch them before they go live, and then I'll choose the name and then make it, you know, schedule it for whenever it's going to go live. But that serves the extra purpose of also giving it one view before it goes live, which potentially helps with engagement, because as far as YouTube is concerned, every view, like, comment, dislikes even, all of that counts towards engagement. So this is why you'll often see videos that have millions of dislikes and no likes popping up as being really successful, because, well, it still counts as engagement. People have clicked on the video. It's the easiest way to become famous. But the more important reason I watch back through my stuff is I'm a writer by trade. That's what I do. That's what I've always wanted to do. Writing is my passion. Writing is what I live for. So, and I don't have an editor. I mean, I've had people who have proofread for me and done editing and stuff, but pretty much, you know, it's a one-man show. This is me doing my thing. So, I read back through my own stuff, so I've learned to not have a problem at all with looking at my own shoes.